Jay Weatherill has delivered his first state budget as Treasurer and the government's last before it faces an election. The result, a record deficit of $1.3 billion, but the government has predicted a return to surplus in 3 years. However, you will help pay for that, with motor vehicle fines and public transport tickets rising. Now, reaction to the budget has been mixed. It's been backed by the public service union and welfare groups, but criticised largely by business. Well, the Premier and Treasurer joins us live now from State Parliament. Mr Weatherill, why shouldn't South Australians feel uncomfortable about carrying the largest deficit in the state's history?
Well, our debt's moderate, Beck, and we've used this budget to invest in jobs and services that help people. Now, we could get back to surplus more quickly, but it would be at the expense of those services, and we were not prepared to do that. We know that our opponents, the Liberal Party, do want to slash into services and jobs, but we're just simply not prepared to do that.
And we'll all be paying higher fees, fares, fines. What do we get in return in this budget?
Well, there's been reductions in areas. We've increased concessions for water, so pensioners won't be paying any increases in their water prices. We've also reduced the motor reg, so motor reg down by $148 for people over the next 2 years. And there's some big investments in road traffic black spots, so there's a lot of areas around town that need better road safety, and some big projects out at Tonsley, big new project there. And also the South Road project to deal with the traffic snarls there.
And on a personal level, what's been the toll for you of preparing a budget as both Premier and Treasurer?
Well, I wanted to step up because people wanted me to take responsibility. The economy needs some support. We think it's the role of government to step in and stimulate the housing sector. We think it's the role of government to step in and help small business. That's why we've halved payroll tax for those small businesses that are doing it tough at the moment. So I wanted to take responsibility. That's what South Australians expect of me. That's why I wanted to take both of these roles on.
I hope you can put your feet up a little bit after this now. Thank you, Premier Jay Weatherill.
Thanks.
You for taking the time to speak to us.
Pleasure.